Let's talk about this thing called vehicle to grid, Jason.
Yeah, another acronym that's come up in the industry. You've got vehicle to home, vehicle to grid, and V2X, vehicle to V2X. Yeah. V2X. So let's talk about vehicle to home. What does that mean?
Well, people are very shortly going to be thinking, what am I doing parking my big battery in my garage at night time and not using the energy in the battery to run my home?
Well, it effectively is, isn't it? It's a giant...
Yeah, it's a giant battery. Now, the work that Tesla had been doing, Jeff Darn, actually, at Dalhousie University in Canada, who's the guru, the battery guru for Tesla, he has developed a million-mile battery.
Amazing.
A battery that will last for a million miles. He's done it for a specific purpose. He's done it not so that the car will last a million miles, but to illustrate to people that using the battery in the car to run the home at night time is not going to degrade the battery, because it's good for a million miles.
Amazing. So you've another life,
yes,
another
that was
purpose.
The exact reason for developing it was to say, well, look, what are you worrying about degrading the battery? Because it's going to outlast the wheels and the shock absorbers, and the car's going to be worn out in other areas by a million miles, which comes to the question of repurposing that battery as well. However, once people are confident that they're not going to damage their very expensive battery in their motor car by using the energy at night time, then that's going to really burgeon, because it leads into another area of this subject called grid stability. Grid stability occurs with renewable energy because they are, by their nature, variable.
Yeah. Solar, middle of the day, generating a lot of energy.
Utilising this vehicle in your garage at dinner time when everyone's cooking, and using some of the energy from the battery, not just in that house, but exporting small amounts of it, bursts of energy into the grid, from everyone's garage, will stabilise the grid at dinner time.
So a Tesla Powerwall or a typical battery is 10 kilowatts. A vehicle, you're sitting 50, 60, 50. 70.
Yes, that's right. So anywhere from 50 to 100.
5 to 6.
Huge.
Or these Tesla Powerwalls sitting in your garage, not being used, that you're only ever putting energy in one way. So I think the whole idea of vehicle to grid or vehicle to home is being able to use your car to support your home usage.
Yes, it's bi-directional flow of energy. The car can and will support the grid at certain times by exporting energy to the grid, and at other times, when in the middle of the day and your car happens to be plugged into a charger somewhere, it doesn't have to be at home, then your car can become a sponge for that excess solar in the middle of the day. And it's a really, vehicle to X, as we say, is a really wonderful mechanism for creating stability in an otherwise difficult to stabilise world.
Imagine in the next 10 or 15 years where half the vehicles sitting in people's garages are batteries, giant batteries. Well, then that really can bring a lot of stability to the
grid.
That's
right. And when they're out, the car's out on the road, there'll be a trivial battery in the house it'll still have a battery, but it'll be a very small one, just enough to get it through the day.
Yep.
When the car comes home, it will charge up that trivial battery and make sure that it's got plenty for tomorrow.
Yep.
If it doesn't, if the weather prediction says it's going to be cloudy tomorrow, and that's another element that's coming in too.
We're getting forecasting.
Yeah, we're getting automated forecasting of weather conditions that allow intelligent systems to make intelligent decisions about energy flows.
So let's hold back some of the battery capacity because we know tomorrow is going to be an overcast day and that we're going to need some power. So put your crystal ball on. Frank, how far do you think really till you start to see vehicle to home or vehicle to X?
Fortunately, we're not moving fast enough. For a thing like that to work, you have to set standards and you have to put sort of rules in place. It's not happening quickly enough. Very, very quickly there will be the availability of these batteries on wheels and the regulatory
framework.
Necessities, yep. Frameworks won't be there. In a way too, that it's now only now that we're catching up with the fact that we have to put EV chargers in around the countryside. It has to happen, so why not get in and do it?
Such a big challenge for the industry is to map out Australia. This is the problem we have. It's unique that we've got such sparse population centred around the coast.
You know, this is a puzzle with many parts.
It is.
And
there's no one solution. The highways need to be covered. Fuel stations need it. Parks, libraries, sporting clubs, homes. They're all little individual problems to solve. How do you do it? But we just need.
And they're not insurmountable. They're very doable. Just have to have the will. And this is where governments are in a position to show leadership. It's really an area where leadership is absolutely necessary.
As we solve these problems and we get infrastructure rolled out and we put more and more chargers where vehicles to connect, that only builds stability in the grid.